Next is a speech to the members of the London ISKCON Temple, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 23, 1968, in Los Angeles.
Ajnana timirandhasya jnananjana salakaya chakshur militam jena tasmai sri gurave namaha. I offer my respectful obeisances and to the spiritual master who has opened my eyes with the torch of knowledge in my material existence of darkness. Ladies and gentlemen, please accept my greetings in the Happy New Year of 1969 and blessings of Sri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, for your kindly participating in this happy meeting of Krishna consciousness. Krishna appeared on this earthly planet 5,000 years ago and gave us the unique philosophy and religious principles of Krishna consciousness in the shape of the Bhagavad Gita. Unfortunately, in course of time, as things change and deteriorate in the material world, people deteriorated and forgot the art of Krishna consciousness. Lord Krishna again therefore appeared as Lord Sri Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, at the end of the 15th century to revive the same Krishna consciousness atmosphere in the human society. Lord Chaitanya's special gift to the fallen souls of this age of quarrel and disagreement is to induce the people in general, the religionists, the philosophers, and everyone to take to the chanting of the holy name of Krishna. He informed us that the Absolute Supreme Personality of Godhead can descend also in transcendental sound vibration. And thus, when we chant Hare Krishna mantra offenselessly, we immediately contact Krishna and His internal energy. And thus we become immediately purified from all dirty things in our heart. Our conditional life of material existence is due to dirty things in our heart. Originally, we are all Krishna conscious living beings, but due to our long material association in different species of life, varying to 8,400,000 of different forms of life, we are accustomed to transmigrating from one form of body to another. In such cycle of birth and death, I, you, and every one of us, although originally spirit soul, and therefore qualitatively one in constitution with the Supreme Lord Krishna, we have identified with this material form of life, subjected to various forms of material pangs, specifically in the shape of birth, death, old age and disease. The whole material civilization is a process of hard struggle of life ending in birth, death, old age and disease. The human society is struggling fruitlessly against these perpetual problems of life in different ways. Some of them are making material attempts and some of them are making partially spiritual attempts. The materialists are trying to solve the problems by achievement of scientific knowledge, education, philosophy, morality, ethics, poetic thoughts, etc. And the spiritualists are trying to solve the problems by different theses like discerning matter from spirit in various ways. and some of them are trying, as mystic yogins, to arrive at the right conclusion. But all of them must know it for certain that in this age of Kali, or the age of quarrel and dissension, there is no possibility of success without accepting the process of Krishna consciousness. Srila Sukadeva Goswami, the speaker of Srimad Bhagavatam, has therefore recommended that everyone, be he a fruitive worker, a salvationist, or a mystic yogi, if actually he wants to be freed from the pangs of material existence, he must take to the process of chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna consciousness is therefore an art of changing our hearts by purification from the dust of material desires. We cannot stop our desires because, as living entities, desiring is the component part of our constitution. Therefore, we cannot give up our desire, but we can purify our desire. Healing of desire is no solution, but curing the desire, disease condition of desire, is the right solution. As such, therefore, this dust of misunderstanding is cleared off. We can see our real position of life and make steady progress towards the ultimate goal of life. We have forgotten the ultimate goal of our life due to lack of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, our entire activity should be executed in Krishna consciousness to revive our lost relationship with God or Krishna. We do not prohibit anyone to cease from the present occupational duties, but we simply recommend that he execute such duties in Krishna consciousness. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never recommended changing one's position of life, but he favored the process of hearing about Krishna from the right bona fide source. One should give up the artificial process of philosophical speculation to arrive at the real goal of life, but one should submissively hear about the philosophy of Krishna consciousness, which is generally inculcated in Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. If one submissively chants the Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, and hears the message of Krishna as it is in the Bhagavad Gita without any malinterpretation, then he does not have to change his position by some artificial method. Simply by the method of chanting and hearing, he comes to a transcendental position which will help him to know God, his name, his form, his quality, his pastimes, his paraphernalia, and so on. We are, however, misled by persons and leaders who have very little connection with God or Krishna. Some of them are denying the existence of God. Some of them are falsely trying to place themselves in place of God. Some of them are in favor of the impersonal feature of God. And at last, some of them, without being able to reach any right conclusion, are accepting the ultimate goal of life as void or zero, in utter hopelessness and frustration. But Krishna consciousness is solid ground for understanding Krishna or God directly by the simple method of chanting the holy name of God or Krishna. Misled by blind leaders, the followers who themselves are blind have failed to achieve the desired success. But here is a method called by the name Krishna consciousness, which is directly offered by Krishna, and the instructions are plainly described in the Bhagavad Gita, given to us 5,000 years ago, and again confirmed by him in the form of Lord Chaitanya 500 years ago. This Krishna consciousness movement is a great art of life, very easy and sublime. This Krishna consciousness movement gives you everything you want without any artificial endeavor. It is transcendentally colorful and full of transcendental pleasure. We prosecute these Krishna consciousness activities through singing, dancing, eating, and talking philosophy received through authorized disciplic succession, and therefore it gives us everything we want without any artificial change of our natural instincts. The consciousness is there in you, but it is now dirty consciousness, and what you have to do now is to cleanse it from all dirty things and make it clear, Krishna consciousness, in pleasant method by chanting the glorified holy name of God, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.